Hey everybody, how's everybody doing today? I hope that everybody's enjoying their weekend, and for those who have been affected by Hurricane Sandy, I hope that everybody's fine and everybody has got their power back. I know the electric and gas is still a problem in some areas, but I hope that everybody is have God in his heart, and I hope that everybody makes it through and that we all work together. Today I'm going to be talking about a very powerful episode that happened in a very brilliant show, which is The Walking Dead. And basically, this was episode 4. And for those who've seen the episode, and you know, that's who I'm going to be talking to. For those who haven't, this is a spoiler alert. So if you don't want to know what happened in that episode, I suggest you turn off the video and find something else to watch. Today we're going to be talking about the very dramatic ending of Walking Dead, which was Rick's wife had finally, well, I shouldn't say had finally, but Rick's wife died due to giving birth to their baby, who either belonged to Rick or belonged to Shane. For those who don't know what happened, basically what happened was that one of the prisoners that Rick was supposed to kill basically didn't get killed by the zombies. He basically set up a trap to take over the prison, and basically in doing so, a lot of the important people got killed in the process. So for example, T-Dog got killed because he was trying to protect one of his mates by making sure that the zombies won't get him. And basically what happened to Lori was that Lori, Carl, and Maggie is Glenn's girlfriend and Carl is their firstborn, they basically got trapped into a closet, and Lori was about to have a baby and couldn't hold on any longer because Herschel wasn't there. So basically Maggie had to do a C-section without anesthesia, and there was a chance that she might die in the process. It was very sad because for two reasons. One, Carl had to do something that I think no one would expect him to do, which is kill his mother before she turned into a zombie. And two, this is what I truly believe in my heart of hearts, that Andrew Lincoln, who played Rick, his name's Rick Grimes, gave the most brilliant performance of so far this season. The ending of that episode when he found out that his wife is dead was probably the most dramatic ending I've seen in a long time. And just how he reacted was just, you felt his pain. It's funny because from season 1 to episode 4 in season 3 up to this point, we've seen Rick's transformation. He went from being a police officer who was clean cut to becoming a survival leader who was just basically dirty, grimy looking. He basically can't. He has to think every 5 seconds to keep this group alive. He's hungry. Yes, that's my cat in the background. Sorry about that. But for the most part, he has gone through such trials and tribulations. And I think he's already trying to fight death every day. He's trying to fight zombies. He's trying to fight human nature. He's trying to fight hunger. He's trying to fight famine, starvation. He's trying to fight for survival every single day. Now we're at the point of the situation where now it's come to the point that he lost his wife and now he's a father, but don't really know if he is the father because you can't really do like a test to see whose baby it really is, because remember, this is a quote-unquote the end of the world. But I do, the topic for today that I like to discuss with all of you is, what will happen to Rick now? Now that we see that Rick is at the breaking point of his life where he has a son who's basically turned killer. His leadership is in question because of his sanity. And now that his sanity is turned to insanity, what happens now? In my personal opinion, I do believe that Rick's sanity is going to be the question for the next couple of episodes, because it questions what type of leader will he be. You have to be a strong-minded leader to see that, okay, you know what, we are at the point that Yes, my cat is hungry. I'm gonna feed it in a minute. Shh, quiet, church. Sorry about that. He gets a little hungry. My wife and I were watching it yesterday, and she made an interesting point too about the show that, you know what, she likes the fact that it's very good. She's a little confused about the governor's background, but you know what, as it develops, she gets into it. But she and I felt the same way that, you know what, the ending was just so good because you didn't expect her to die at the end. Like, I know in the comic books it was done a little differently, but I kind of like the way how they're doing the storylines for the TV. And believe me when I tell you, I do feel that Rick going insane will be very, very interesting to see because I do believe that he loves his wife. I think he felt betrayed because of the fact that she had, you know, she committed infidelity, and also too, the idea that, you know, she was kind of like the wicked character in a sense. It was always her thing was always you do what you got to do to keep us alive. And the fact is that now that Rick has done all these things, now he lost the one person that he loves so much. What happens now? Because now we see Rick's breaking point. And I think I love the way that the show shows you that these characters do have a breaking point. Because in some point, you go from being a cop to being a leader, and then you're thinking, and then what happens when something you love so much is gone? Because remember, we've seen Rick in such dramatic scenes where, like, I haven't seen nothing this powerful since when he killed Sophia, and that was just as dramatic enough. But the scenes where he's like going through, okay, he killed Sophia and that was sad. Then he's letting the group know that this is not a democracy, though that was powerful. Now we see Rick at the point where he can't take it anymore. And I think from, I give it like maybe, I don't think through the whole season, but I think in about maybe three, four episodes, we're gonna probably see that insanity mark and see how his mind is basically gone in a sense. Because think about it, everything he's done is to protect his group, and not only the group, but his family. But now we're gonna finally see that in the end, you know, of the end of the season, because we don't know how this is gonna play. I do believe that there is gonna be a war between him and the governor, but for the most part, I don't know if the governor's gonna play into it and trying to manipulate Rick during his insanity. But for the most part, I think Rick is gonna do kills. I even believe that he might turn on his own group because he's not thinking straight. I think what this group will probably do, and this is just a guess, is that I think they might lock him up into solitary confinement just until he can calm down. Because remember, Rick is now a father now. And now that he's a new father to this baby, people have to worry about this baby. And they also got to worry about him too because he is the leader and he can keep this group alive. But at the same time, you know, with all the zombies and all the betrayal and all, you know, the governor is going to be coming soon and, you know, we know he's a sadistic bastard. So the thing is, Rick has got to get his sanity back and they have to work on getting his sanity back. But right now, I say I don't really believe they're going to focus on that throughout the whole season. I think, you know, I give it three or four episodes. They might deal with that, and then maybe Rick will put it aside and get back to his leadership. But for right now, if he doesn't ever get back to that point, it would be great to see because it would be great to see throughout the rest of the season, how do you take the fact that your own son had to put down his mother because the mother didn't want to turn, she's going to turn into a zombie. And the fact that your little boy, this good-looking boy, who is now turned into a cold-hearted monster in a sense. So, has this apocalypse affected him too? Because we all know that he loved his mother, and the fact is, how will Carl change? Will Carl be now the charming little boy that, you know, will his good looks and his boyish looks become affected because of this tragedy? Will his mind be now, or okay, you know what? I'm not that little boy anymore. Now I'm a killer and I'm ready to kill zombies. So, he's even at a change point. That scene, I do have to admit, was probably the best scene I've seen so far. And you know something? Before I come to a close, I do want to say that if this show does not get an Emmy or a Golden Globe, and if Andrew Lincoln does not get an Emmy or a Golden Globe, then you know something? Another rip-off of a show, another underrated show that doesn't give a chance. So you know something? Again, Andrew Lincoln gave the most brilliant performance this season and continues to do that. I think he was born to play the role of Rick, and I think he did a phenomenal job of showing just how much a man can take, and then the breaking point hits him. Because believe me when I tell you, I think if I was in his spot and I lost my wife and I had this new child, I think we all would be in that breaking point too, especially not only are you a new father, but your leadership is in question and the insanity is taking over. So, tell me what you think about Lori's death. Was everybody surprised about what happened, or did everyone expect it? And more importantly, do you think that Rick will ever get his sanity back, or do you think this is just, he's lost beyond control? Because as we've seen now, Rick is now at the point where he's lost it. So I wanted to ask you all, do you think Rick will ever get his sanity back after losing his wife, or do you think that Rick's leadership is in question and that Daryl should take over the leadership? Because right now the group is getting smaller, and as the group gets smaller, whose lives are going to be next to be taken? So hit me up with your comments. Tell me what you think about the episode of how we lost Lori, and tell me what you think of the show. But for the most part, I have to say before I come to a close is that it is probably one of the best shows I've seen so far, and I know it's going to get better. So all of you take it easy. I can't wait to see tomorrow's episode. Hopefully I'll have some lights because believe me, the electric here has been going on and off since Sandy. So, I'm keeping my fingers crossed. But for the most part, I hope at least, well, I won't be able to watch it tomorrow because my wife is into the Days of Our Lives marathon. But, hopefully tonight, I'll watch the episode again, and tomorrow night I'll be able to, see Sunday's episode and see what happens then. So, like I said, hit me with your comments, tell me what you think. Enjoy your weekend, and I hope that everybody has a great night. So take care of yourself. God bless you all.